Hello friends, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video we will cover parameters. So this is the agenda. We will see what are parameters and what are the different type of parameters, like overriding parameters and symbolic parameters. So we will see what are parameters. Parameters are variables used to pass external values to the procedures at the time of invoking them from JCL. So this is just to make them generic and they can be reusable. So this is the syntax for both overriding and symbolic parameters, which we will see in the next slide. So this is overriding parameters. It is used to override parameters for a procedure which are calling from the main JCL. So what exactly this mean? Suppose you are calling a procedure. Inside that procedure you have coded one time and you have given some time for that particular step. Now you want to override that. So to override that, you can mention it here, like how I mentioned here. So we are calling procedure 1 and here we have given time is equal to 1440. So it will go to the procedure 1 and inside that it will change the time parameter and it will allocate this much of time to that procedure. So this can be done at DD level as well as the exec level. So now next is symbolic parameters. So it is used in procedures and JCLs to represent a value which can be supplied later by invoking a JCL. Suppose you have a set of lines, like it's a block of code, and inside that only you need to change the program name every time. Apart from that, all other parameters and all other statements are same. So to do that, what we can do is we can make them generalize and we can use symbolic parameters. Like here I'm using A as a symbolic parameter. So every time I call this program and I can set the value of A. So from the invoking JCL, suppose in one of the JCL I need to execute program 1. So I will set the value of program 1 as PGM1 and then I will call this PGM ampersand A. So this ampersand A value will be replaced by PGM1. So by this we can make use of the same code in multiple JCLs. So this is all about parameters. Now let's see all these functions practically.
We will start with overriding exec statements. I have coded one JCL for this. This method is used to override parameters which are present on exec statement. Here I am calling a procedure catproc and I am passing the values of region as 256. So what it will do, it will go to the catproc and it will replace the region parameters. So we'll go to catproc. In catproc, we have mentioned region parameter as 512. And in JCL, from where we are calling this catproc, we have mentioned region as 256. So how we do it? We give the parameter name, then the proc step name. So parameter is region and the step name is step 2. So here you can see the step 2. So it will come here to step 2 and it will override the region parameters. It will be more clear when we'll see a demo of this in symbolic parameters, because you cannot see region parameters whether they have increased or not. Now we'll start with overriding DD parameters. In this, what I have done is I'm calling again a catalog procedure, but I'm overriding that DD parameter. Here I'm overriding the PDS itself. Previously it was picking load from load library. Now I have pointed it to load 2. So we'll see the procedure again. Here you can see the DSN name is tutorial.point.load and I have given tutorial.point.load2. So I have overridden the step lib. So here step 2 is this one, this step 2 of the procedure, and then dot step lib. Step lib is the DD statement, DD name which you want to override. So when I will submit this job, it will take the load from load to library instead of load libraries. So I will submit this. Completion code 0. I'm going to spool. So this is our job, DD1. I will open this. So we'll go to the JCL. Here you can see our parameters are in effect. So it is picking load from load 2. And this statement is overridden, load 1. So we'll go and check the output. Here you can see overriding parameters, new load library 2. So this is what I have mentioned in the program 2 while compiling. And I have compiled the load in the load 2 library. Now we'll start with symbolic parameter. Symbolic parameters can be used in procedures as well in JCL to represent a value letter supplied by invoking JCL. So we used to set this by set command. So what I have done is I have set X as program 1 and Y as program 2. You can mention a name also, but it's optional. So set X is equal to program 1, set Y is equal to program 2. So here what I have done is I have written program ampersand X. So when we'll submit this job, this ampersand X will be replaced by program 1 and ampersand Y will be replaced by program 2. So we'll submit this and we'll check the results. Completion code 0, F9. This is our latest job. Open this and we'll go to JCL. Here you can see the value substitution JCL. PGM is equal to program 1. X is replaced by program 1. And PGM ampersand Y, this is replaced by program 2. Now we'll check the output. In program 1, this is in stream processor. In program 2, this is a catalog processor. So they are just display statements, nothing else. Now we'll see how to pass parameters, how to pass symbolic parameters in a processor. I've used an existing JCL. Here what I've done is, I've given the value of X is equal to program 2. This is similar to overriding exec parameters, which I was talking about in the starting of the video. So we'll go to catproc 2 and we'll see what is happening there. This is catproc, we'll open this. Here what I've done is, I've defined one procedure. And in program, I have given ampersand X. So this processor is expecting a value for X. If we will miss the value of X, it will append. Here I am passing value of X as program 2. When I will submit this job, this ampersand X will be replaced by program 2. So we'll submit and check. Completion code 0, we'll go to spool. This is our JCL. Here you can see substitution of ampersand X is equal to program 2, which we have passed from our main program. Mean JCL. So we have given X is equal to program 2 and here it is replaced by program 2. We'll see the output. So it is printing catalog processor. This is all about overriding parameters and symbolic parameters. In the next video, we'll cover some IBM utilities.